To the latest on the path of destruction left behind by last week's tornadoes. Officials in Alabama are calculating their death toll. That's because they fear some victims may have been counted twice. Currently, officials believe 236 people died in Alabama and 328 people were killed in all. That makes it the deadliest twister outbreak since the Great Depression. Tonight, an Upstate family is remembering their loved ones killed in that violent storm that hit Alabama. News 4's Keisha Foster joins us live and local from the Anderson Newsroom. And Keisha, this family also has a reason to be thankful.
Yes, Nigel. David Vermillion of Donald's lost his brother, sister-in-law, and 15-year-old niece when a tornado ripped through Fort Payne, Alabama. However, his 9-year-old niece, Abby, survived.
I hadn't been able to bring myself to look at TV or anything like that. We have got to go out there Thursday morning and, you know, pick up the pieces and take care of some business out there. I'm sure I'm going to see more than I want to.
On his front porch in Donald's, David Vermillion talks about the storm that killed his older brother Dan, Dan's wife Hilda, and their daughter Courtney.
So I was riding down the road at the time and pulled over. I first learned about it about 9 o'clock Thursday morning. I learned that they were killed in the tornado about 9 o'clock.
However, one family member survived, 9-year-old Abigail. She escaped with a broken leg and is now under David's care.
It's unimaginable what this little girl is going through. But we're here. The rest of her extended family is here. She has her good moments and you know, not so good moment. She's able to laugh some and, of course, able to do a tremendous amount of crying, too. But she's doing okay, and by God's grace, we're going to get through it.
Dan Vermillion and his family moved from the Upstate to Alabama 3 years ago.
I know the devastation of tornadoes. I've seen it before. It's just heart-wrenching, you know, because I know there were other families out there that perished. And, you know, my heart goes out to them, too. You know, the whole thing was just unreal.
The Vermillion family will receive friends and family from 6 to 8 this evening at Pruitt Funeral Home in Honeypath. Now, the funeral for Dan, Hilda, and Courtney will take place Wednesday at 3 p.m. at the Donald's Church of God. A memorial fund has been set up for the family at the Commercial Bank in Donald's. Keisha Foster, WYFF News 4, live in the Anderson Newsroom.
Keisha, thank you.